How do I look?
You look so pretty.
Right, is a car upside down here?
Yeah.
So there's hay bales on the motorway.
Hay bales?
Yeah.
Highways just telling us if they are landing, they'll have to close both sides.
Hello, Highways, it's Ambulance Control. 9:31 ETA for landing on the helicopter.
Hello. Who else was in this car? Just you?
Just me, yeah.
What's happened?
Coming down the motorway, started snaking, tried to slow down, lost control. I think I did a 180 at one time.
Yeah.
I lost the trailer, turned over.
Were you knocked out at all?
No.
No?
Conscious all the time.
I could ideally do with having a look at your head. We don't need any more crews. There's only him.
498, we're on scene on this incident in the motorway. There appears to be one patient and we are going to immobilise him. Helimed is just landing. You can stand the other resources down, over.
You got the helicopter here as well.
Please just back up when I ring on circle 21.
Hello, team.
Hello.
Hi.
This is Tom.
Yeah.
Been driving this car along at approximately 50 miles an hour.
Yeah.
Started snaking with a trailer on the back and flipped.
If I press really hard just in the middle, is there any pain or there?
It's okay as it is. No
problem. Okay, okay. I think I'm happy to clear his neck clinically, Janet. Have you got any strong objections to that? Sit yourself back.
Swing your feet up. Have you got that?
Bit of a bump. We'll get you on the ramp, okay?
Right, are you ready? Right, we'll get you on. Are you okay there?
Yeah.
All things considered, you've been extremely lucky.
Very lucky.
Yeah. Someone's looking out for you today, aren't they?
Aren't the police good stopping the traffic for us?
2, 7, 1, 0.
Who's your next of kin?
Diana, that one, I mean.
Diana, who's Diana to you?
My partner.
Partner.
498, thank you.
Do you have a brief update of the patient's status, over?
Yeah, it's a 63-year-old gentleman. He's been driving down the motorway. I towed a trailer with bales of hay on it. This trailer's began to snake. It's spun a few times and he's ended up rolling across 3 to 4 lanes of the motorway. He's got a laceration to his scalp. The bleeding has stopped. He's been very, very lucky. So we're on our way to Oldham now. We get to some incidents where you think, how's this person managed to get away with this? Life is unpredictable. You never know what's going to happen. Everything could be going really well one moment, then the worst thing that's ever happened to you happens, and you have to make the best of that situation.
No.
Across Greater Manchester, there are now 91 ambulances on scene and 42 patients waiting. The temperature has hit a May bank holiday high of 26 degrees.
Alpha 498.
But an 86-year-old male. They've not actually specified what the primary concern is with this patient.
They've given us a few obs and they are as follows.
Temperature 34.7.
Stretcher, defib, drugs bag.
Yeah.
Response bag, obviously. So we'll grab all the stuff. Yeah.
Hello. I'm Christine's daughter.
Daughter, right, lovely.
Thanks
so what's been the problem with Arthur? So how does he look to you?
I've never seen him look that poorly.
Right, Arthur. Let's have a good look. Just a sharp scratch on your finger, just to check your blood sugars. Sorry. Oh, hang on, you're running away there. Sorry, sharp scratch. Done.
So this is just going into your nostrils, Arthur, OK? And that just goes behind your ear.
Oh.
Not the comfiest, but we'll just get you a bit of fresh air.
What's that tattoo from?
Oh, we had that when you were 14.
14?
Wow.
Bit of a rebel.
He just went with his mates, you know, and when he got home, his mother went mad. And
she did.
She got a big scrubbing brush and bleach and tried to rub it off. My grandchildren think it's marvellous.
Arthur, can I borrow this arm again? I'm sorry I'm a nuisance.
There, you get it there, don't you? Yeah. We're nearly finished messing, Arthur. Sorry about this.
I'm so sorry, Arthur.
His kidneys were working 20%, but they're not even working that now.
Sorry, Arthur, we are nearly done.
Arthur, I'm sorry.
They've been very sore, his fingers.
I know, I think that's the...
They're looking after you, Dad. They're not messing you about, they're trying to make you feel better.
I'm going to try and pop a little needle into your arm. I'm sorry, this is just to try and get your sugar levels up.
His blood pressure's low, his heart rate's a little bit low, his blood sugars are low, so there's something, clearly something going on, whether it's an infection somewhere. He's still going to need to go to hospital anyway.
Do you want to stay here?
Yeah.
Or do you want to go to hospital?
Yeah.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah.
Yes. But you understand that by staying here, you might become very unwell. You understand that, don't you?
Yeah.
So his wishes are not to treat?
No.
And you were saying not to treat as well?
Yeah.
Clinical support. Morning, Clinical Hub. Would I be able to speak to a senior clinician, please, regarding this job we're on? It's a gentleman who's in a nursing home and there has been some discussions in the past regarding whether he would like treating, and he doesn't want treating and he would like to die. See, that his wishes and the family's wishes are to be left here to be cared for till the end of life. Brilliant. Oh, great. Thanks a lot, Andy. All right, thanks for your time. All right, bye. Bye. He's in agreement.
Yeah.
And that's it. And hopefully they can get some palliative care sorted.
Yeah.
If it's needed. It is very difficult to watch somebody deteriorate in front of you. I do understand partly what they're going through. My late wife, she didn't want any more treatment. Because it couldn't be cured, she just wanted to be comfortable and pain-free. It's the last decision they're ever going to make. It's giving that person some control at the end of their life.
It's been lovely to meet you. All right, good luck. All right. Thank you very much, all right.
You take care. All right, lovely to meet you.
I wouldn't be where I am now if it wasn't for my first wife. I wouldn't have moved to Manchester. I wouldn't have become a paramedic. She was 36 when she died. My children, they were 9 and 6 at the time. So I suppose that's all her legacy, really. She's a wonderful.